daylight saving time by providing meals, providing some money for local charities, and we're going to explain how that all works. We've got Dan Jacobs here from Odd Duck, and we've also got L. Maxwell McKissick here, who's one of the organizers of the event. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning. Good morning.
All right, so let's get right to your recipe here, Chef. You're making one of the most popular dishes that you serve at Odd Duck.
Yeah, this is something that's been on the menu since we opened up. It's the bacon-wrapped dates. It's very simple. It's something that I think anybody can do when they're at home. The hardest part, literally, is getting the pit out of the date. We use tweezers, but I mean, you could totally use a pair of pliers at home. Basically, it comes out just like that. We take this guy and we stuff it with the Gouda cheese. This is a smoked Gouda, but you can really use anything you want.
And this looks like a thicker cut of bacon. Should you go to the butcher for this?
You can. If you go to like most grocery stores now, they'll have bacon in the deli case, like by the pound. And I would go to that for sure.
All right. What is Serve 60?
Well, Serve 60 is a national non-for-profit that promotes volunteering, giving back 1 hour of your time, ours being daylight savings time. So we have six chefs using six ingredients, cooking three courses in 1 hour. You know, all of us want to win, but the ultimate goal is to raise money and resources for in partnership with Feeding America Southeastern Wisconsin.
All right, fill in the blanks for us.
Oh, exactly. I think Dan did a great job. Six chefs competing. It's like Iron Chef meets a cause, Tom. So we're bringing together six of the top restaurants. They'll have 1 hour, as he said, to incorporate at least six of the most preferred ingredients for food banks and food pantries. And they'll serve it to a three-panel person judges who will then judge them on different criteria. And we also have an opportunity for any of the viewers who want to participate to get in on the action. They can vote for the People's Choice winner. So we have a couple of different ways that judging can take place.
And where does this happen?
It's taking place Rail Hall in Walker's Point, historic Walker's Point neighborhood, 131 West Seaboth. And for any of the viewers who think they can't make it out, we have a new component this year. You can donate to help us raise awareness and resources for hunger relief as well. Last year, we raised enough resources to provide 20,000 meals for families right here in southeastern Wisconsin. And we'd love to exceed that goal this year.
All right, and as we wrap up the recipe here, so you're putting this stuff, this is going in the oven?
Yeah, we're going to do this in the oven about 350 degrees, about 10 to 20 minutes, depending on how long the bacon takes to brown. Once the bacon's brown, though, we're good to go. And then you just pull it. Basically, the toothpick holds everything together. Pull the toothpick out, the bacon stays in place.
And the finished dish is here. You're serving this with a little something on the side?
We do a little saba, which is a grape, reduced grape must. It's kind of like a sweet reduced vinegar.
Something that we can pick up at the grocery store.
Oh, totally! No, absolutely. You could just take balsamic vinegar and reduce it down with some sugar. But don't forget, the tickets are $60 for general admission, $100 for VIP, and you can get the tickets at servetastegive.com.
And coming up next weekend, right?
Yep.
Next weekend.
All right. Thank you both for coming in to see us this morning. The dates look terrific. I know a lot of people have enjoyed them down at your restaurant.
Thank you very much.
All right. If you would like more information, log on to our website, tmj4.com, and click on links. We'll be back with more of today's top stories right